3, 2, 1.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Travis Scott, nah, don't go to his events. I mean, pray for him. He's really satanic, him and Drake are very satanic. They sold their souls to the devil. They even admitted in some of their music that they sold out, you know what I mean? So, my thoughts are, pray for them, stay away from them, don't listen to them, don't even buy CDs for them, you know what I mean? Man, you just gotta pray for them, you know what I mean? To repent, because he's gonna be judged one day, you know what he did. You know, he cares about the money more than the fans, he said they love his fans. Eight people died at the concert, at that heart, it was the best thing that happened, honestly. Eight people, sounds like a sacrifice. You know, shout out to my, that's what I think about, God's God, stay with him, don't buy some tuna, so if you're around your town, don't support him, pray for him, that is. This country will get heavy, people do drugs, people got injected with something in their leg, infection. And don't miss Bible Buzz Part 32 this week. The late dog from the beach, here in March. And that's it, that's my words. I'm Travis Scott, so hey. Pray for him, repent, maybe even change Christian, you may know, you don't know, but just stay away from him, Kanye West, all of him, you know what I mean, he says he's Christian, I don't think so. You know, man's, come on. Alright, people need to repent in Jesus' name. Alright, DJ, soul of God, alright, I bless.
Hey everybody, today I decided to do a worship mix because I haven't done one ooh, long time. But still doing the Bible Buzz this week. Maybe Friday, I might switch it, I'm not sure. To part 32. Still on Mark with Dr. McGee. And today is going to be a worship mix, so enjoy it. God bless you, in Jesus' name. And then the verse of the day is going to be in the bottom below. Heavenly Father, we pray right now, Lord, those who listen to this channel, download the content, that they start studying your word, worshiping you, your glory, your honor, until one day you come back. In Jesus' name we pray, because the signs are there. Amen. God bless. Enjoy the mix, everybody.
Listen to me. I'm gonna tell you what you gotta do.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Bob, yo, head, before they fill it up with air. Clap, clap.
Oh,
obsession with the things this world to make us happy. Yeah.
Where belong it? couldn't do this on my own. I'm breathing in a different rhythm. I'm walking at a different pace. I'm freely falling into your head. I'm running wild in your grace. Now I finally come. Fear. In and out, I found my purpose.
Thank you. soul, for my soul. Everybody's gonna die. Don't everybody live, though. Sometimes I look up to the sky and wonder, do you see us down here? Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Do you see us down here? Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Do you see us down here? Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Do you see us down here? Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Listen. Yeah, everybody wants change. Don't nobody wanna change though. Don't nobody wanna pray till they got something to pray for. Now everybody's gonna die, but don't everybody live though. Sometimes I look up to the sky and wonder, do you see us down here? Oh Lord.
Things. We look in the sky like, why ain't you listening? Watching the news in our living rooms on the big screens and talking about if God's really real and where is he? You see the same God that we're saying might not even exist becomes real to us, but only when we're dying in bed. When you're healthy, it's like we don't really care for him then. Leave me alone, God, I'll call you when I need you again. Which is funny, everyone who's sleeping in pews don't blame God for our problems like he's sleeping on you. We turn our backs on him, what do you expect him to do? It's hard to answer prayers when nobody's praying to you. I look around at this world we walk on, it's a smack in the face, don't ever tell me there's no God. And if there isn't, then what are we here for? And what are y'all doing down there? I don't know, Lord.
See us down, yeah, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh
Lord. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, the power to be strong and the wisdom to
cumpleañero. Tú caminando en tu traje rojo. Te vi y sin mentir se detuvo mi mundo entero. Pasé la noche echándote el ojo. Y hoy han pasado los años y aunque parezca extraño estás aquí.
Entregar ele a direção. Chama o mestre. warrior. Mi padre me dio el armamento necesario desde el acontecimiento de la cruz del Calvario. Se garantizó que yo sería legendario. Perdón, sé que no se trata de mí, sino de Cristo en mí, pero yo soy el referente. Lleva en la frente una etiqueta que dice: le tiró al conejo y al residente. Que tire la primera piedra el que no lo pensó, el que no lo dijo ni me señaló. Que Dios bendiga y que perdone el que escribió que fulano y que mengano eran más cristianos que yo. No mencionaré sus nombres nuevamente, ya lo dedujiste, tú eres inteligente. Siempre aparece algún creyente contraproducente que prefiere a Barrabás, evidentemente. Todo cristiano es mi hermano y compatriota, ya Jesús ganó. Ya se agota. Yo sigo en movimiento, sobre pavimento, en modo resistencia estoy. Con base y fundamento, soy un instrumento, Jesús mi sustento. Y voy nadando contra la corriente, cumpliendo la misión intensamente. Conectado a la fuente, continuamente viviendo el momento.
Se acabó. No, no se acabó. Ya. Yeah. Doy un giro 360 en una pista suculenta con un bajo que revienta.
Sube lo que se sienta.
Redimido representa siempre con sal y pimienta, con un flow que se incrementa
de forma violenta. Bro, ya quiero que se llene la iglesia. Bro, ya quiero que se llene el concierto. Bro, yo quiero un mundo sin máscaras. Aquí estoy soñando despierto. Un clásico de River contra Boca, el estadio lleno y sin tapabocas. Quiero dar abrazos, quiero ir al cine, que el distanciamiento termine. Quiero ver libre al pueblo cubano y al pueblo venezolano. Que la gente vote con buena memoria y que nunca gobierne un tirano. A lo mejor estoy pidiendo demasiado, a lo mejor escribí esto emocionado. Es que espero lo mejor, pero para lo peor estoy preparado. Mientras tanto sigo en el redil, entre las trincheras con mi fusil, apuntando de forma sutil, al menos preciado y vil. En mi cabeza hay más ganas y en mi corazón hay más ganas de seguir haciendo canciones para evangelizar a los panas. Con Alex Urte y con Funky soltamos el disco de uno. Humildemente y con modestia la pusimos en Neptuno. A mi Dios toda la gloria, solo a él y a más ninguno. Ahora les presento Momentum en el momento oportuno.
Oye, y en mi República Dominicana, ¿cuándo es que van a aprobar el nuevo Código Penal? Le estamos seguimiento.
Stay with all my problems. I was so afraid, and when you saw them, you would turn your back on me and leave. Cause in the silence, my insecurities are like a siren taking over me.
Me amas y hermosa tú me ves. Something so unique, the way you touch my soul got me sprung and weak. The way you got me feeling, it's like I'm on top of the ceiling with a feeling of suffocating. I can hardly speak. I can't say a single word. No ni una palabra. Cause your love is magical. It's my ego, abracadabra. You got me hypnotized. Struck me right between the eyes. In a trance, so take my hand and lead me to the promised land.
I want you to possess my body. Possess my soul.
Come and possess my soul. Take over my mind and soul.
I want you to possess my body.
This is a picture of a scene that is going to take place someday in heaven at the throne of God. You see, you can't change your past, but you can determine your destiny by deciding for Christ. And when you do that, Christ changes your past. He wipes out all the sins of the past.
If you gotta start somewhere, why not here? time, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now.
Choose you this day, not tomorrow, this day, whom you're going to serve. And many of you are going to have to decide tonight what is the number one priority in your life. All the way through the Bible, choices, choices, choices.
Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints to wear.
Tonight, he's willing to come into your heart and change the direction of your life and give you a peace and a joy that you've never known before. And the people ask me why I continue to preach. And I answer, because the word of the Lord has come unto me, and he tells me to go and proclaim his gospel as long as I have breath.
Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world. Love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints to wear.
Message of repentance, yet the people of Nineveh believe his message. And the Bible says that the greatest revival, the greatest evangelistic campaign in the history of the world took place in Nineveh. It was a city probably of 600,000 people, and the whole city from the king on down repented.
Oh, tonight could last forever.
God had mercy upon not only the king, but all the people, and all the people were saved. That could happen here.
Tonight's the night.
Somebody here worthy. He is the lion. The root of David hath prevailed to receive a new heart from him. I ask you to come tonight. I'm going to ask you to get up out of your seat all over this great auditorium and come and stand quietly and reverently here in front. As an indication that you're receiving Christ, that you want a new heart and a new life from this moment on, that you're going to change the direction of your life. The Holy Spirit has been speaking. He's been preparing your heart. Now you come and receive Christ.
If I'm being honest, I didn't think you'd stay with all my problems. I was so afraid when you saw. You would turn your back on me, baby. Cause in the silence, my insecurities are like a siren taking over me. I can't hide them. Even then you see the past as me that I can't see. Something I
Creepy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Right, that was a good word. My PowerPoint, check that out. Stay at one station, and thanks to TLA. Sister with the Fifth. With him and Fifth part of it. Check them out. And pray for Pastor Glory to change, to be more real. Stop celebrating Halloween. I'm still with that. No, I pray for that pastor, all pastors. Supposedly, they're supposed to be true. So, for all the things that we do, you know what I mean? But thank you for checking out my mix. Thank you, you know, share. You could download it, everything. You could do that. It's free. My channel is free. And the only thing I ask is support my church. That's the only thing I ask, to support the channel. Support my church by donating to the church. There you go. All right, so God bless you. In Jesus' name, all things that you give us, Lord. Be with me tomorrow. I worked at Biola now. Thank you, Jesus. Soldiers out. DJ for God. Jesus coming soon. Exposing the devil and his kingdom. Heaven exposes the kingdom of darkness. That the kingdom of darkness has control over the world. So wake up. People, rise up. Find Jesus. And go against the system in Jesus' name. Because they're going to get their judgment too. Soldiers out.
Hola, Dios te bendiga. Bienvenido a su canal Cristianos Actualizados. Mi nombre es Ismauri Castaño y estamos muy contentos porque ya en esta comunidad somos más de 218 mil suscriptores. Damos muchas gracias a cada uno de ustedes que nos han ayudado a tener ese crecimiento a través de su suscripción y también por medio de ustedes compartir este contenido en sus redes sociales. También invitamos a todos aquellos que aún no forman parte de este canal que pueden hacerlo ahora mismo dándole aquí debajo al botón de suscribirse y activando la campanita de las notificaciones. Vamos de inmediato a ver la noticia que traemos para ustedes en el día de hoy. Actualmente la India, así como otros países de Asia, Medio Oriente y África, son duramente perseguidos por causa de la expansión del Evangelio, la cual ha dado libertad a muchas personas que habían sido víctimas de distintas creencias que los habían llevado a la decadencia en muchos aspectos. Las declaraciones citadas por el sitio de Wire afirman que un sacerdote hindú de nombre Swami Paramananda pidió en una manifestación contra las conversiones religiosas que se decapitara a los cristianos que abandonaran el Islam porque supuestamente es una conversión forzosa. Las conversiones del Islam al cristianismo, siendo forzadas entre comillas, son un delito grave en la India, lo cual provoca grandes persecuciones contra los creyentes que incluyen los peores castigos, desde los físicos hasta los legales. Este líder, Paramananda, es reconocido por ser extremadamente radical en cuanto a su creencia se refiere del Islam, además de provocar varias reacciones violentas contra las minorías religiosas en la zona. En este caso, la fe cristiana es el blanco predilecto de estas masas extremistas. Por ello, se reunieron este y otros líderes más, además de sus seguidores opuestos al cristianismo, para manifestar en contra de la conversión del Islam a la fe en Jesucristo, siendo respaldados por varios partidos políticos que, con el pasar de los años, se han unido a este tipo de actos de intolerancia religiosa. El líder hindú, según The Wire e International Christian Concern, expresó lo siguiente: A los cristianos que llegan a la conversión, ahora dirás que estoy esparciendo odio, aunque soy un santo, pero a veces es importante encender fuego. Te lo estoy diciendo, quien venga a su casa, calle, barrio, pueblo, no perdone. Hasta ahora se teme que las declaraciones de dicho líder provoquen una revuelta violenta y sirva para alentar a los extremistas en contra de los cristianos. A pesar de esto, cada día se levantan muchas más personas que desean llevar a otros a los pies de Cristo y que pueden alcanzar la salvación sin importar la clase de riesgos que tengan que afrontar por causa de la predicación del Evangelio. Hasta aquí esta noticia, esperando que haya servido de información y edificación para cada uno de ustedes. Y como siempre en este tipo de noticias, les rogamos que llevemos a estos países y a nuestros hermanos principalmente en oración, porque es evidente la gran persecución que hay en contra del pueblo cristiano. Queremos leer su comentario, así que le esperamos aquí debajo. No olviden dar su like en este video compartir este contenido en todas sus redes sociales. Hasta aquí les ha reportado su reportero de Cristianos Actualizados, Ismauri Castaño. No dejen el video todavía, porque ahora van a ver un contenido que será de mucha edificación para cada uno de ustedes.
Veo a muchos cristianos hablando de la persecución como si no existiera. No, porque un día seremos perseguidos. ¿Un día? Eso lo dices porque tu madre no está muerta. Porque a nosotros no nos han pegado un tiro en la cabeza. Vete a la República del Congo y pregunta cómo tratan a los cristianos. Vete a Mumbai, a la India, y pregunta cómo tratan a nuestros hermanos. Vete a Corea y pregunta cómo tratan a los hermanos. Vete a China y dile a los hermanos, ¿por qué no estáis en las plazas evangelizando? Y pregunta cómo tratan en China a nuestros hermanos. Vete a Nigeria y pregúntales qué pasó la semana pasada con aquella iglesia que cerraron por fuera con 100 personas adorando a Dios y le prendieron fuego. Así como el COVID mucho nos parece un poco una patraña porque en casa no ha llegado, la persecución creemos que no está porque en esta sala no ha empezado. Pero esas cosas existen y son reales. Y te digo una cosa, así como una enfermedad empieza en un núcleo y se va expandiendo, la persecución de la iglesia está allí, pero está empezando a correr por todas partes. Está empezando a correr por todas partes. Comunicados oficiales a pastores en Europa ya llegando. Quien hable de homosexualidad, multa. Quien hable de familia solo hombre y mujer, multa. Quien diga que hombre, hombre, mujer, mujer no es familia, multa. ¿Y qué vamos a hacer? ¿Callarnos? Vamos a enfrentarlo. Pero después de 3 multas, no hay multa. Bueno, a la tercera, cárcel. ¿Pero por qué? Incitación al odio, intolerancia. Eso está llegando. Lo que ustedes no lo saben. Cuando vas al ayuntamiento y les dices, mira, quería abrir un negocio en Hospitalet. Ah, sí, ¿el qué? Mira, un bar. Ah, no, claro, bares, más mejor. Toma la licencia, toma la de la terraza, toma esto, y en 2 días, bar montado. ¿Tú sabes qué pasa cuando vamos al ayuntamiento y decimos, mira, es que la iglesia se me quedó pequeña? Queríamos abrir un local mayor. ¿Para qué un local grande? ¿Para qué una iglesia con un local grande? Cada uno debería vivir la fe en su casa. Le digo, pues entonces también que las cervezas se las tomen ahí. ¿No? Ah, pero me gusta este sitio. Ahí no se puede. ¿Pero por qué? Porque ahí solo queremos industria. Vale, pues me gusta este sitio. Ahí tampoco se puede. ¿Por qué? Porque tiene que tener tantos metros. Digo, ya, pero es que entonces lo que me estás diciendo de otra forma es que no puedo en ningún sitio. Tú te apañas. Es así, lo que no lo sabéis porque vosotros no vais a pedir los permisos. Y vas a abrir y te dicen, el techo tiene que ser más alto. Dinero para el techo. Ah, la luz tiene que ser otra. Ah, las ventanas doble. ¿Pero por qué? Ni que nos pongan a pegar unos tiroteos aquí para que doble ventana. Porque tiene que ser así. ¿Sabes lo que buscan hacer? Dejarte sin un centavo para que digas, no puedo. Me voy a quedar en esta sala con 20 personas. Eso es real. Eso es real. Para una iglesia que se abre en la zona de Cataluña, 2 se cierran o 3. Todavía no nos han puesto la pistola en la cabeza. Pero la primera persecución que llega a todos los lugares es bajo leyes. Para llegar a matar a nuestros hermanos en China, para llegar a matar a nuestros hermanos en Corea o en Nigeria, lo primero que se puso es una ley. Prohibido profesar fe cristiana públicamente. Y aquí esa ley va a llegar.
Check the flavor that I'm bringing, the one and only D.R.E. And you know I keep the hits ringing. Tonight, tonight,
all familiar lights.
Mr. Clean Magic Eraser.
Cares about what I care about. God is never too busy or preoccupied to take time for you. Listen, if it concerns you, it concerns him. So here were two men with a very real need, and Jesus responded to the need. So what do we learn about prayer from this story? In times of crisis, they pray, and so should we.
Today on A New Beginning, good insight on prayer from Pastor Greg Laurie. And he has more insight to come in his message called The Refreshing Power of Prayer. But if you didn't hear every word of today's encouragement, interruptions do happen, you can hear what you missed by going online to harvest.org. Again, the title of the message, The Refreshing Power of Prayer. Or subscribe to our podcast by going to Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, or Spotify. Well, we're making available a fascinating new book called The Jesus Music. Pastor Greg, you wrote a book called The Jesus Revolution, talking about the Jesus movement.
Yeah.
How much is Jesus music linked to the Jesus movement?
Yeah, Dave, I would say it's very linked. It was, well, they say the music of the 60s was a soundtrack of a generation, and that's true. And the Jesus music, which would be late 60s, onto the 70s, and really to the present day, is also a soundtrack of a generation, but it's a Jesus generation. And it's very important music because it was born out of revival. It was revival music in its early stages. It's worth noting that in the beginning we called it Jesus music, and later it became an industry known as contemporary Christian music. Mm-hmm. But it really started with just songs about Jesus. And I had a front row seat. We were attending Calvary Chapel of Costa Mesa in 1970, which was the epicenter of the Southern California Jesus movement. And all these bands were forming before our eyes. Every week it was like a new band. There was bands with names like Love Song, of course, Gentle Faith, Joy, Country Faith, Mustard Seed Faith, lots of faith back in those days. But what was really unique was these were songs that were written to speak to people. They were songs that expressed this newfound faith that these musicians had found after coming to Christ. And so it was very exciting to see. And then it became a whole industry. And now there's contemporary Christian music stations, of course, and huge events and concerts that happen all around the world. But it started very simply, and it started in revival.
And we have a brand new book that sort of tracks the history of Jesus music back in the late 60s, early 70s.
Yes, we do. It's called The Jesus Music, written by Marshall Terrell. And by the way, there's a documentary film put out by the Irwin Brothers and Kingdom Productions by the same name, an amazing film. But this book, The Jesus Music, written by Marshall Terrell, tells you the story. And I was able to have some input in the writing of this book because I was there. I wrote the introduction to the book as well. And as a matter of fact, some of you may recognize Marshall's name because we have written three books together. One of them is Johnny Cash, The Redemption of an American Icon. Another is Steve McQueen, The Salvation of an American Icon. And of course, Billy Graham, The Man I Knew. So Marshall is a great writer. He's a good researcher, and this is going to take you back to the beginning of this music to the present day. There's a lot of stories you'll read and a lot of things you will learn, and I'm sure you did not know about some of your famous artists out there that have touched your lives in so many ways.
Yeah, it's such an interesting book. You'll love it, even if you're a relative newcomer to Jesus music. Again, it's the new book called The Jesus Music, and we'd be glad to send a copy your way to thank you for your partnership with us in making these studies available each day. It's only through listener support that that's possible. So thanks so much for your generosity. Write us at A New Beginning, Box 4000, Riverside, California, 92514. Or call 1-800-821-3300. We can take your call anytime. That's 1-800-821-3300. Or go online to harvest.org.
You know, sometimes we can't always make it to church, but here's the good news. Church is coming to you. It's coming to you on your TV screen, or on your tablet, or your computer, or even your phone. We do it every weekend, and it's called Harvest at Home. We have worship. We have a message from the Word of God. If you want to find out more, just go to harvest.org. And join us this weekend for Harvest at Home.
Next time, more insights from Pastor Greg's new series called Refresh. Practical pointers coming on making our prayer lives more productive. Join us here on A New Beginning with pastor and Bible teacher Greg Laurie.
A New Beginning, sponsored by Harvest Christian Fellowship, pre-recorded. Thank you, Pastor Greg. And I'd just like to stop down and pray for all of us right now. K-Kelly family, if I may. Father, this world has such a way, and the forces in it, of nipping and biting at us until we are weary. God, I love what Pastor Greg was just talking about here, how our lives will be refreshed when we devote ourselves to talking to you in prayer. So there's two or more gathered in your name right now. There's thousands we gather to pray to you, Father. Allow us to remember what Pastor Greg was talking about, that we will be refreshed when we spend time with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, so, so good. Hey, join Greg this Sunday, Harvest, Riverside, Orange County, in Irvine, 9 a.m., 11 a.m. He's in the teaching series on the Book of Acts, The Upside Down Life, and the virtual church service, Harvest Home, streaming all weekend, live.harvest.org. And one more note, Pastor Greg does have a new program called Refresh. It takes sermons and vignettes of Pastor Greg and pairs them up with Christian music, and it's perfect. It's at 9 a.m. Sunday mornings on our sister station, 95.9 The Fish. Worship music combined with Pastor Greg's. It's the message behind the music. 9 a.m. on our sister station, Sundays, 95.9 The Fish. Just thought I'd throw that out there.
Morning, noon, and night. Always here for you.
I love KKLA. I listen to it all day long.
99.5 KKLA. Find hope here.
What happens when you're in a serious car accident? David James, well, Bill and his wife were in and out of the hospital for a year, but they had the presence of mind to call Berglund and Johnson instead of one of those quick settlement TV lawyers.
If we had people that were just phoning it in and just checking out boxes, I don't think we would have come out in near as good a situation as we are now.
What did Berglund and Johnson do for them?
There were financial and legal and social moves that were crucial that we had to make, and they would jump right in there and with some kind of personal involvement would help us make those kind of decisions.
So if you're seriously injured in an accident, call the personal injury legal team that really cares. The Berglund and Johnson Law Group. 1-800-4-IF-HURT. There are no upfront costs.
They got in there and they helped.
1-800-4-IF-HURT.
Remember, you don't have to live with missing or decayed teeth. With Implanova Dental Implants from Dr. Zaday, you can have new teeth in just one day. Wouldn't you like that? Just one call gets you started. Dr. Zaday is the inventor and manufacturer of the Implanova system. So if you have missing or damaged teeth, or older dental implants did not work for you, call Dr. Zaday for a free consultation at 310-273-2020. Credit cards accepted. Financing available. 310-273-2020.
KKLA's Thankful Thursday. Tell us why your pastor and the church staff should receive a free lunch. Submit your story at kkla.com/thankful. Then every Thursday, the KKLA Street Team will provide a pastor and his church staff with free lunch. Thankful Thursday is sponsored by Hope Cafe and Catering. Remember them for your parties and family get-togethers. And by America's Christian Credit Union, americaschristiancu.com/switch. One entry per week. Submit your entry now on the KKLA app or at kkla.com/thankful.
Somebody who loves you. It's home sweet home here in the house of the Lord.
Worship can make all of the difference as we gather together with God's people and see things accurately, biblically, and correctly. You know, when you isolate yourself from other believers, you lose perspective. You can become fearful and confused and angry and bitter.
Bring your heartache, bring your burden. You can lay them down at the
Jesus said, "Wherever there are two or three gathered in my name, I am in the midst of them." When we gather together, we grow stronger in our faith. Let's get back to church.
We belong here. Step into the house of the Lord.
99.5. KKLA. KKLA family, it's David James with a dear friend of mine's real life, Regina Pastore.
And David James.
And every Saturday night, 7:30 on Real Life with Regina Pastore. Gina, what's your hope for the show? What do we talk about?
We talk about the things that people don't like to talk about. That's what we talk about. We'll talk about the need to move forward after grief, being a mom during this COVID crisis. And we challenge and encourage you and discuss things like, what do you need to let go of?
And Gina, what a delight to have Dr. John Mark Reynolds join us once again this week. Of course, Dr. John Mark Reynolds was the founder and director of the Torrey Honors Institute at Biola University. And he joins us once again this week. Are we trying as Jesus followers to bend to the way culture says we should believe? Or do we study God's word and allow the Holy Spirit to dictate his truth? It's this Saturday night and every Saturday night at 7:30 here on KKLA.
We hope you'll join us.
KKLA plays contests. For the rules, go to the contest tab at KKLA.com. Listen on Odyssey.
KKLA FM Los Angeles. Find hope here.
All right, we're in the Life of Purpose series with Dr. Jack Graham. Pull up a chair, or maybe you're on a hike or walking, strolling, driving. God's plan, my purpose. A Life of Purpose. PowerPoint, sponsored by PowerPoint, pre-recorded.
Welcome to this edition of PowerPoint with Jack Graham. A little later in the program, we'll tell you how you can get a scripture journal on the book of Ephesians. But first, here's his message, God's plan, my purpose.
God's plan is perfect, God's plan is positive, God's plan is providential. But the fact is that God uses both pressure and pleasure to bring about his purpose and plan in our lives, to fulfill our destiny. And his primary purpose and plan in our lives, of course, is to strengthen our character and make us more and more like Jesus each day. And so God arranges our days that he might fulfill his destiny and his purpose for each one of us. Romans 8:28 says it so very well. For we know that God is working in our lives. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good. For those who are called according to his purpose. Now, frankly, this is one of the most misunderstood verses in all of the Bible. This verse does not mean that if I just think positively, everything's going to work out in my life. It's so much more than that. It doesn't mean if I believe everything's going to turn out well at the end. Because we know in life, in a fallen world, not everything in this life ends well. But the fact is, we can know that God is doing something significant, that God is doing something magnificent in each one of our lives. And so what I want to do today is just really break this verse down for us, because there is so much power and strength and so much significance in every word of this powerful verse. So Romans 8:28, it begins by saying, "And we know." And we know. What do we know? We know that our lives are not left to random chance or religious karma or just good luck or bad luck. We know something. Not conjecture. Not wishful thinking. But this is a promise from God that transcends time and conquers every circumstance. Now, it seems impossible to say it, that all things, that we know that all things are working together for good.
And while it may seem impossible on the surface, with God, all things are possible. There are many things I can't explain about life. And, you know, one of the brightest days, one of the best days is when you figure out that you don't have to answer every question. But rather, there are imponderables and unexplainables and explicables in life that we dare not even try to explain. But there are certain things that we do know, because we don't live by explanation, we live by revelation. And the question at the bottom line is this: can we trust God with our lives? Can we count on Him in the midst of favorable and unfavorable circumstances to know that He is at work? So often we see this word "know" appearing in Scripture. Job said, "I know that my Redeemer lives and in the last day will stand upon the earth." Paul said, "I know whom I have believed and am persuaded that He is able to keep what I have committed, that which I have committed unto Him against that day." I know, I know. John tells us that we can know that we have passed from death unto life. He also says that we can know that when He appears, we will be like Him, for we will see Him as He is. We know, we know, we know, we know. This is not probably, this is not maybe, this is we know. So what do we know? We know that God is at work in our lives. We know that God makes no mistakes, that life is not a series of incidents and accidents, but that God, by His hand of providence, is leading us. You say, "Well, I don't know. How can I trusted God? I believed God that He would work all these things out for me, and yet I'm living in disaster. God, why? Why am I living in these conditions, in this situation? If You love me, why am I in the middle of this tragedy?" A lady by the name of Helen Roosevelt was a British medical missionary in the Congo a number of years ago. In the midst of an uprising there, she was taken captive, brutally beaten, tortured, and raped, doing the will of God, and yet a tragedy, a travesty. And later she wrote of her experience, and Helen said this: "I must ask myself a question as if it came directly from the Lord. Can You thank me for trusting You with this experience, even if I never tell You why?" God has trusted each one of us with our own set of unfair circumstances and unexplainable experiences. So the question today is, can we trust a God even though we never understand why? Knowing that everything that enters our lives is filtered through His fingers, through His hands of providence, which, may I remind you, are nail-scarred hands. That everything that He allows to enter our lives comes with the tag "permitted." Permitted. It doesn't mean that everything is good. We know that bad things happen, man. But the fact is that we can learn to accept what He gives, even though it is painful, even though there is pressure to break. We can find in His providence, in the good hand of His grace, the goodness of God, knowing that everything in our lives is under His control. Under His control. Elton Trueblood said this: "Faith is not belief without proof, but trust without reservation." Again, I say it all really comes down to this: can you trust God? Will you trust God?
knowing that our circumstances may not change. But as we submit to His work and His will in our lives, we will change. And we become more and more like Christ as we yield and surrender our will to His perfect will. That's when God's plan becomes our purpose. For we know that God causes. There is a grand design, not fate, not blind luck, but that God is at work.
You're listening to PowerPoint with Jack Graham, and today's message, God's plan, my purpose. The book of Ephesians is relentless in its message of reconciliation, unity, and the new life you have in Christ. In fact, it's the perfect book to read this time of year because each of these themes comes alive in the Christmas story. We'd love to help you dive into the uplifting book of the Bible by sending you the beautifully designed Ephesians ESV Scripture Journal. The Ephesians ESV Scripture Journal is our thanks for your gift today. This is the last week of this offer, so call today. Call 1-800-711-5719. That's 1-800-711-5719. You can also text the word PowerPoint to 313131. Text PowerPoint to 313131.
And don't forget to visit jackgraham.org, where you can shop our e-store, give a gift online, or sign up for Dr. Graham's free daily email devotional. Our website again is jackgraham.org. Now let's get back to today's message, God's plan, my purpose.
God's plan includes everything that happens to you. Everything? Yes, everything. It doesn't mean that everything is good, but it means that all things are working together for good. And that includes our failures, our mistakes, our hurts, as well as our hallelujahs, our sins, our sickness, disease, divorce, death, that God brings the good, the best, out of the worst. And to prove that, He gave His own Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And at the cross, and by the power of the resurrection, God brought life from death. God worked it out in His own plan for His own purpose. Everything God is working together. You see, this is why we can say that peace then comes. Security and certainty comes. When we are trusting God. What does Isaiah 26:3 say? Isaiah 26:3 says, "You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you, for he trusts in you." Peace comes in the midst of pain and struggle and pressure when we trust God. Psalm 91 says that we live in the shadow of the Almighty. We are in His refuge, always under the shelter, under the shadow of the Almighty. That's the safest place on earth, in heaven and earth, to be. Now, in the letter to the Romans, Paul again and again and again and again recounts the grace and the goodness of God. And Romans 8 is the conclusion, really, of all that he's been saying up until now regarding what God's grace has accomplished and is accomplishing in our lives. It was D.L. Moody, the famed evangelist, who once said, "I would rather live in Romans chapter 8 than in the Garden of Eden." Said, because in the Garden of Eden, man sinned and fell out of the security of that place. But in Romans chapter 8, it begins with no condemnation and it ends with no separation. We are secure. And Romans chapter 8 is that great chapter in the Bible which teaches us of the security of the believer in Christ. We're told that we are forgiven by the grace of God. that we are clean, justified by His grace. We have been told that we are now strengthened by the Holy Spirit because we are indwelt by the living presence of God. We are now the children of God, the sons of God. We have been given wisdom in Christ. We have an incredible and sure hope in Christ. We are even promised assistance in prayer as the Holy Spirit is our prayer partners. When we don't even know what to say and how to pray, when we just groan deep within and we realize that the Spirit of God is praying with us and praying for us. We realize that there is a certainty in Christ and a security that is in Him that lasts forever. And no wonder Paul, having said all of these things, pauses in the midst of this great testimony and says, if God be for us, who can be against us? If God is for us, He loves you, and He's promised to take care of you every step of the way. And when we fail and flail around, when we fall, when people disappoint us, when we disappoint ourselves, God's constant compassion and caring is always with us. No wonder. No wonder the apostle concludes this great eighth chapter by saying, this is why neither life nor death nor angels nor principalities nor powers nor things present nor things to come nor height nor depth nor any other created thing will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Jesus Christ. God knows there will be times when we are afraid, when we are alone, when we are sad, when we are defeated, when we are tempted to doubt. And that is why again and over again, He gives us these promises to assure us of His plan, His purpose, and His very presence in our lives. When we are alone and afraid, God in His Word assures us of His presence. When we are ashamed, God offers us His grace and His forgiveness. When we are angry and disappointed, God gives us hope and encouragement. When we are anxious and wringing our hands and worrying about the future, God gives us assurance and peace and serenity in Him. Why? Because we know. We know something. We know that our God, who is dependable and faithful, is at work in everything that has to do with our lives. I love the story of Joseph. Joseph was a young man with a dream, God-given dreams in his life. And yet those dreams were shattered when he was still a young man, when his brothers, who despised him because of his dreams and because of his faith and favor with his family, they sold him into slavery. You remember the story perhaps from Sunday school. They put him in a pit. He was sold as a slave to Egypt. And while a slave diligently working, there was a unique spirit, God's spirit working with him. And he rose to some prominence, even within the prison, but then into the house of Potiphar, a well-known Egyptian statesman of that day. And yet he was falsely accused by Potiphar's wife and unfairly thrown into prison. His life is wasting away. Many times Joseph could have cried out, God, why? God, where are my dreams? And then when God, in His own time, in His own way, by His own hand of providence, brought Joseph to that place of prominence in Egypt himself, where he in effect was the prime minister over all of Egypt. Those very brothers who hated him and sold him into slavery stood before him. These men were in his hands to do as he would. And what did Joseph say? Joseph said, you meant all of this for evil. This is found in Genesis 50 verse 20. It's the Romans 8:28 of the Bible. You meant all of this for evil against me, but God meant it for good. You see, even the worst things in our lives, the best things, the least things, the worst things,
God even uses our sin and our failure.
Maybe you've experienced some tragedy of failure. Maybe it has been the breakdown of a marriage or a home or a family. Maybe you have yielded to temptation too many times. Did you know that if you will come back to Him in repentance, He will restore you and He will make things brand new and He will do something in your life today that you never thought possible, because God is working all things together for good. Everything. All things. Where sin abounds, grace much more abounds. And for what purpose? To what end? To those who love the Lord and to those who are called according to His purpose. This is not a blanket promise. This is a believer promise. The fact is that if you don't know the Lord, if you're living in resistance and in opposition to God in your life, things aren't working together for good. They're working together for the most painful result, the worst result imaginable. Everything in life, even the good things, will work together for your bad. This is a promise for God's children, for those who love the Lord, those who are called according to His purpose. And remember His purpose, what is it? To make us more like Jesus. Just a final word, some action steps for us today. Number one, affirm today that God's plan for your life is good. Trust God's plan as good, perfect, and acceptable. Number two, stay focused on the end result. Thirdly, give thanks and rejoice in everything in your life. And then finally, never give up. Romans 5:4, endurance produces character and character produces hope. The Apostle Paul said, I'm sure of this, that he who began the good work in you will perform it, he will perfect it until the day of Jesus Christ. He will. We can know this.
You're listening to PowerPoint with Jack Graham, and today's message, God's plan, my purpose. Every believer in Christ needs a strong grasp of Ephesians, which is why we want to send you an ESV scripture journal on this powerful book of the Bible. With journaling pages next to the biblical text, you can read through the book while taking notes, recording insights, and jotting down your prayers. And now's a great time to dive in, because Ephesians is the perfect book to read at Christmas. With themes of reconciliation, unity, and new life in Christ, you'll rediscover the new life that's yours in Christ. The Ephesians ESV Scripture Journal is our special thanks for your gift to help boldly proclaim God's Word through PowerPoint. This is the last week of this offer, so call today. Call 1-800-711-5719. That's 1-800-711-5719. You can also text the word PowerPoint to 313131. Text PowerPoint to 313131.
And don't forget to visit jackgraham.org, where you can shop our e-store, give a gift online, or sign up for Dr. Graham's free daily email devotional. Our website again is jackgraham.org. Pastor, what is your PowerPoint for today?
Elton Trueblood was a noted American Quaker of the 20th century and a theologian. And here's what he wrote. Faith is not belief without proof, but trust without reservation. Now, don't you love that? Let me say it again. Faith is not belief without proof, but trust without reservation. For you and for me, there are times when we can't fully understand all that's going on in our lives. There are things that absolutely make no sense to us. There are painful times and perplexing times that cause us to question God's plan for our lives. But it is in those times that we must truly and fully trust God, to have a faith that is without reservation. And how do we do that? By understanding the truth of Romans 8:28 and 29. Here it is. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to His purpose. For those whom He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, in order that He might be the firstborn among many brothers. Now, we get the word synergy from the word work in this passage. In other words, God is working. He is working with synergy in your life, taking all the forces and circumstances and situations of your life and synergizing them. That is, working them all together for your good and for His glory. That's why you can truly trust God, even when things are not going as you expected. Yes, God does have an incredible, wonderful, beautiful plan for your life. And that plan is indeed your purpose. Trust Him today to work everything together for your good and to accomplish His glorious purpose.
And that is today's PowerPoint. Remember, when you give a gift to PowerPoint, we'll send you an ESV Scripture Journal as our thanks. Call 1-800-711-5719. That's 1-800-711-5719. You can also text the word PowerPoint to 313131. Text PowerPoint to 313131. And join us again next time as Dr. Graham brings a message about living in God's love. That's next time on PowerPoint with Jack Graham.
PowerPoint with Jack Graham is sponsored by PowerPoint Ministries.
PowerPoint, sponsored by PowerPoint, Dr. Jack Graham. I got a number of notes inviting me to read that devotional I had read just a little while ago, in relying on God and not on ourselves. This life is so stressful, and we find ourselves sometimes stressed. A lot of it, part and parcel, is that we are depending on ourselves to find the answers or to make more money, or you know what I mean? So I'm going to read this here in just a second. It's about 76. A 90 tomorrow into the weekend. That's Weather Check presented by DuckDuckGo Inc. Start cooling it down on Tuesday. So this is God speaking, and this is from a devotional that I've been reading called Abundant Life in Jesus by Nancy Guthrie. And this is God speaking. People may tell you that I will never give you more than you can handle, but don't listen. It's not true. You will often find yourself in situations that require more faith, more perseverance, more love, and more wisdom than you have on your own. And when you find yourself in that situation, you'll realize how much you need me. In fact, you'll be desperate for me. The truth is, you were just as desperate for me before you found yourself in this place. You just didn't realize it. Sometimes you need to be shaken so that you can see your sin of self-reliance. Then you can repent of the sin and become more God-reliant. It's not a sign of weakness to depend on me. It's a sign of spiritual strength to live day by day in recognition of your utter dependence on me. 2 Corinthians 1:8 and 9. We were crushed and overwhelmed beyond our ability to endure. And we thought we would never live through it. In fact, we expected to die. But as a result, we stopped relying on ourselves and learned to only rely on God, who raises the dead.
Daily inspiration.
It inspires me. Inspires me to just want to do more, serve more, be more a part of God's kingdom.
99.5 KKLA. Find hope here.
What is it that makes you uniquely you? Well, DuckDuckGo doesn't think that's any of their business.
So much. My wife and kids are going to be so excited. Thank you.
I love it. The whole family is coming. We would love for you to bring your family another.
Three, two, one. Put the break it down. See you when we see you win in the city they call Long Beach. Put the stretch together like my homie G.O. Feet. No one can do it better like this. That and this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this. Then we ain't got no love for dog.
So just chill to the next episode.
SEO season. We going up. What's going on, mamita?
Hey, Brianna, this is Sarah. I'm just going to give a shout out to my sister and say happy birthday.
Aww. Happy birthday, sissy. Now, I want to remind you, your song of the hour to get hooked up with a pair of tickets to go see Queen Naija Monday night is Thakkari, Bad Bunny, Jay Cortez, and Snow the Product. As soon as you hear Thakkari, I'm going to be looking for call number 10. So keep it right here. I'm Brianna's Power 106. Let's get it.
All lights out for me, all lights out for me. Lightning strikes the beach, 80 degrees, warm it up for me. Finally free, found a part of me, and I want you to see. This month I done lost three friends. Early morning brainstorming, normally I can't sleep in. Sometimes I just wanna restart it, but it all depends. If I'ma be that same young Logan from West End, but my heart is rose and the crazy part ain't got no pen. Me back interior came with sheepskin. Still remember when I just had three pens. Now I'm the one everyone call on, cause I got deep hands. But told me to wait to beat the game.
Completamente gratis.
Si tu crédito no es perfecto, no te preocupes. Tenemos programas especiales para cualquier situación y trabajamos con más de 100 bancos.
ABC Tonight. Your favorite artists are back together for country music's biggest night.
When it's real, feeling's hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hear half a breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Watching us while we pray for you. Every day we pray for you. Till the day we meet again. In my heart is where I keep you, friend. Memories give me the strength I need to proceed. Strength I need to believe. My thoughts big, I just can't define. Wish I could turn back the hands of time. Us in the six, shop for new clothes and kicks. You and me taking flicks, making hits, stages they receive you on. Still can't believe you're gonna give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Jack FM, playing what we want.
Wow.
I own a home. I just got married. I have identical twin boys. I'm a part of two organizations that do charity work. And I also have another full-time job working as a peer recovery coach. You know, recovery is possible, and you don't just have to use drugs or drink to be in recovery. Everybody's recovering from something.
Yeah.
And I just want to encourage other people, man, take yourselves back to your maker if you feel broken.
I love that one simple statement, one simple story, a few short words changed your life, changed the path you were on, changed your destiny.
Everything, man.
Why you only hit me when you drunk though? When the club closed and you end up at the front door.